Hey everyone, for those of you who don't know, I'm Carin, so hello. It's quarantine and I'm bored, so I decided to film a video on my Ancestry. At the beginning of 2020, I decided to order the Ancestry DNA test kit, which is basically a saliva-based test. So you like spit in a tube and then you send it off for analyzing. And they say that it can take between a month to 2 months before they send you back your results. And mine took about, I think, a month and a half. So it didn't take that long, but I was excited. So I'm a colored person from South Africa, which basically means I'm mixed race. So all the mixed race people in South Africa is classified as colored. And they say that we are genetically one of the most diverse people on the planet, which is quite interesting. I'm sure a lot of people watching this video get the famous old
"What are you?"
question, and trust me, I've gotten it a lot throughout my life, and generally I just say that I'm colored because I am, but I've never been able to give a detailed answer, because to tell you the truth, not many people in South Africa actually know where their ancestors come from. Let's get into my family. Both my parents are colored, their parents are colored, and so on. I don't really know much. If I had to guess what I am, I would definitely say a big percentage of South African hunter-gatherers, because that's the indigenous people of South Africa, where they say most colored people are mixed with. And then my mother, she does have a few white people in her family. So I'm guessing European, and she said that her father said that they're from Scotland. It's always like so-and-so said kind of thing. No one ever really knows. And then my father, his family is from Cape Town, which is basically has a strong presence of Cape Malay. And let's get into my results. If I look down, it's because my laptop is right here. So if I look down like that, I'll try not to. But yeah, so you log on and it says, "Hello, Carin." And then there's three columns: your DNA story, your DNA matches, and through lines, which is something you have to subscribe to. Disclaimer: I have already seen my result, so I filmed my initial reaction, but the angle isn't that great, so I decided that I needed to redo it. When you log on, there's a pie chart of what you are. And yeah, it says your DNA story. So let's click onto that. Once you've clicked DNA story, it brings you to a map, a colorful map, and the colors represent where you come from. My biggest percentage is 38%. Germanic Europe, which is very shocking. I was not expecting that at all, but it does make sense because, like I said, my mother does have white people on her side of the family, but the fact that it's Germanic European is a bit weird, because I thought it would be more Dutch or Netherlands, because I don't know, that's what I thought. And my mother was even more surprised because her father's been telling her all along that they from Scotland, or their family, or their history, or whatever, you know. And then my next percentage, so I'm just gonna I'll try go through this very quickly because it's quite a lot. So my next biggest percentage is the Southern and Eastern Africa hunter-gatherers, which is basically the indigenous people of South Africa. And if you do click on the percentage, it'll show you a brief history of the people of that area. And they say that this group is drawing attention from researchers for their genetic diversity and their cultures, which I think is pretty cool. I would like to know more. My next percentage is 9% from Congo, Cameroon, and Southern Bantu people, which is around the area of South Africa. Next, we have Southern and Eastern India, which I don't know where that comes from. Next, which is this one, I have no idea. It's 6% Eastern Europe and Russia, and it says primarily located in Austria, Belarus, I don't know, Bosnia and all those places. So I think that's cool. It's pretty close to Germany, so I'm assuming it could be from there. Next, I have 4% from the Philippines. From here onwards, my percentages get really small. So yeah, it's just like little hints of places. 2% from Ireland and Scotland, 2% Eastern Bantu people, 2% England, Wales and Northwestern Europe, 1% Melanesia. I don't know if that's how you say that, but that's the islands around Australia, and it includes New Guinea and places like that. I have 1% Iran and Persia, then 1% Middle East, 1% Ethiopia, 1% Southeast Asian, and 1% Portugal. That's my history. So after getting my results, I was really excited and I wanted to know where all of these genetic links come from. And I just Googled Cape Malay ancestry, and I came to this really interesting article, which is by sahistory.org. And in this article, they basically say that the Dutch people who came to South Africa back then had colonies in Southeast Asia, and anyone who opposed the colonization of their country was sent to South Africa or the Cape of Good Hope as political prisoners. And some of the people who came are from the Philippines and from New Guinea, and I think also some from West Africa, East Africa and Madagascar. So yeah, that all makes sense because it's all around the same area. Yeah, so all of that combined is me. My feet. I'm really glad that I did this test. Didn't change my life much, but I know what I am now, and I hope you enjoyed the video and that it didn't feel like a history lesson. I hope it was a little bit interesting, and yeah, keep safe during this time, and if you'd like to, you can hit the subscribe button. Bye.